Lumbar puncture. This procedure is used for the diagnosis of central nervous system disorders including meningitis, encephalitis, subarachnoid hemorrhage and idiopathic intracranial hypertension. Key anatomy. The iliac crest is identified and palpated with the physician's hand. The physician's thumbs are then placed medially to palpate and identify the spinous processes in the midline of the back. The interspace where the thumbs fall approximates the L4-L5 interspace and is the appropriate location to perform a lumbar puncture. In adults, the L3-L4 space can also be used as it lies below the spinal cord. Indications. Suspected subarachnoid hemorrhage, patient with thunderclap headache with syncope, severe or atypical headache with new neurologic deficits, headache with altered mental status. Suspected CNS infection, patient with unexplained fever associated fault with lethargy, coma, shock, new neurologic deficit, nuchal rigidity, photophobia, uncontrolled seizure, or associated petechial rash or unexplained fever in infants less than 28 days old, in infants with extreme irritability, and in infants less than 6 months old with new onset seizure. There are other non-urgent indications such as for workup of multiple sclerosis, Guillain-Barré syndrome, etc. In the emergency department, it is most commonly used for the assessment of headache, unexplained fever, sepsis workup in neonates and altered mental status. Contraindications. Severe coagulopathy or thrombocytopenia, presence of infection in the skin or soft tissue at the puncture site, suspected spinal epidural abscess or a likelihood of herniation due to increased intracranial pressure as evidenced on CT scan. Anesthesia. If patient is uncooperative, moderate sedation may be necessary. However, for a cooperative or comatose patient who is not agitated, local anesthetic with lidocaine is sufficient. Postoperative care. No specific post-procedure care. Previous recommendations including having the patient lie supine for at least 30 minutes to minimize the risk of a post-epidural headache. However, recent literature has shown that there is no significant decrease. Possible complications. The most common complication is a post-epidural headache. It is typically self-limiting but can last up to a week and cause significant pain. Other complications are less common including infection, bleeding, including the development of an epidural hematoma, cerebral herniation, radicular pain or numbness or back pain. LPs performed at the proper level, below L3 in an adult and below L4 in a child, ensure that you are unlikely to damage the spinal cord making corda equina or nerve root injury possible, but very uncommon.